Hey there, so welcome to part two of my strumming video. The reason I broke this into two parts, even though the whole thing is less than 10 minutes, is because this part addresses a very specific question that I see often. What is the strum pattern for... whatever, something. Well, I'm going to say this, and you might get mad at me for it, because people do sometimes. It really doesn't matter. It's not a big deal. Now, the people who get mad at me, the maddest at me when I say that, and just outright don't believe me, tend to be people who listen to and play a lot of heavy metal and classical music. Now, the reason for that is because those guys are used to having a specific part that they have to play a certain way. Like, that's how the song goes, and that's how you always play it, and that's it. Well, yeah, that's good sometimes, but not all the time. I mean, we're talking songs here. These are all about the melodies. What the rhythm that you're strumming, the harmony, the chords to, that's really not as important. You know, that's all just all about establishing feel. So I'm going to show you a simple way to sort of get into a song and get the feel of it and figure out what sort of rhythms to play. And then I'm going to spice it up a bit and play it in a few different styles so you can see that even though I'm playing different rhythms, the song is still perfectly recognizable. It's still the same song, it just has a different feel. So, I'm going to use the song A Little Help From My Friends by the Beatles. Just easy song, and pretty much everybody knows it. So the chords are just E major, F sharp minor, and B7. Easy song, three chord. So, the first thing you do, just play each chord one time and sing the song. And this will help you to get a feel for where those chord changes happen. Yeah. What would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. There we go. Starting to get it. Now, just play quarter notes, downstrokes. You know, maybe four times for each chord or however long that chord lasts. What would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? You get the idea. And now you probably have a good feel for the song, so now you can start mixing it up. For example, I could kind of play it more similar to how the Beatles did it. You know, what would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Or I could up the tempo and give it like a real rockin' feel, play it in straight eights, like, what would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Or, hell, I could do it like a little ska sort of thing, maybe, like... Yeah. Let's see. What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? You can see the song is still perfectly recognizable, but it has a totally different feel. So, whenever you go on Ultimate Guitar or, I don't know, whatever tab site you go to get your chord list, or if you figure the chords out for yourself, and you're having trouble figuring out, like, well, what's the strum pattern? I don't know what to do. Well, just start singing the song. Play the chords where you think they go, where it sounds like they belong, and just get a feel for it, and then just do what comes naturally. I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. Like John! What is on your phone? You. I'm going to keep that at the end.